But either way, here we go. The third, or the fourth game for the of the day. The first one of the final eight. And off we go.
Yeah, and it looks
we're
like...
We're going to start with Pizanka. The one who got two first places in the first two games, I believe.
Our first place champion currently goes with a tier, which is very interesting. So they chose to go for that over...
over anything else.
Yeah, and that makes me think that potentially they're more in favor of mages and that whole Astral game start plus transitioning into Aeotian late game, that kind of shenanigans.
That is a very early Varus.
I'm excited to see how they play because they were in first place. We haven't seen them. They weren't really somebody that was seeded super high. So I'm curious to see how they play the game.
Yeah, and he comes in with a bang with two first place finishes in the first two games. Kind of insane considering how many big names there are in this tournament. And
yeah, and I would like to see what they decide to do with this Varus, if they just end up selling it and picking up the Heimer, or what the plan is with this. What do you think?
He's heavily considering that he gets something out of this, but unfortunately he doesn't really get out. And he's going to sacrifice the pairing of the Heimerdinger.
Yeah. Chooses to keep the Varus. I like that.
That is a Swift Shot combo right there.
Yeah, we do see the Swift Shot potential. Maybe we'll see gold get picked up here and then a Nidalee gets picked up and we just see Astrals and we can see a Varus reroll type thing going on. I'm not too sure, but we will find out.
We'll see as gold is going to get picked up, even more stuff, I guess, is the best way to say it. And here we go. The augments are in. And someone is not having a good time. I actually don't know. Was that a good oh no, or was that a bad oh no? But we'll see. The cybernetic is going to get picked up.
You never know, but it looks like. I'm getting distracted by all the yelling, but it looks like potentially we might see a level up into Astrals coming down here with double Bruiser. And a Varus here. We see the Varus getting the Sparring Gloves. I like this a lot. I love slamming items early like Sparring Gloves onto your units that you know are going to go on there anyways.
He's also running Cybernetic, so you're getting even more value if you put at least one component on a unit.
Oh, yeah. We're spreading out the items here for the Cybernetic and also just in general giving stats. I like a lot. I was talking about that.
Frontline is even more beefier with a Varus who can hit harder. And we're off Frozen Heart early on this Kane.
I think Frozen Heart is one of those items that's just never going to be bad. And when you have an Assassin start, I think that is absolutely huge.
It is absolutely necessary.
Doing a
at
ton
this
of
point.
Work. This Frozen
and
Heart definitely won the fight.
Kane
for
uncontested. There's the gold,
Ram
though.
Kev. We also see Shimmer Scale, too. This is a really, really strong start. Getting gold off the Shimmer Scale items this early is absolutely massive. And one way to honestly just snowball out of control.
Yeah.
We'll definitely have to keep an eye on Ramkev going later into the game, see if that gold advantage ends up snowballing.
Surprised he's prioritizing the Astral more than anything.
It looks like the screen went black, and we're on Discord for some reason.
This is the new look of TFT.
I do not know what's happening here. But we saw this.
We saw a good couple of people are a fan of Pizanka now.
Gaining fans one game at a time.
Here we go. The next round. What's it going to be? Two Astral comps going against head-to-head. But the Nidalee with the Triforce, not doing so hot. He's going to go down. And easy win for Pizanka, but that's a 1-1 start. And we've talked about this a good amount of times whenever we talk about the early game. 1-1 start is never a good thing.
Yeah, it's definitely brutal for Void Sense, although I'm pretty sure that was he's 0-2.
On the side of Pizanka, it's either you win streak now
or yeah.
If you lose, you're kind of done. That's a rise, though.
I mean, I think Pozonka's in a position where they can just probably win streak out. Like, I don't think it's that bad to win here. You can go off and get four more wins. Obviously, not as good as winning five rounds and having that huge streak, but you can definitely, with this board,
definitely
get
when
four.
He levels up, he's going to have that win streak going, especially with that rise pickup.
Yeah, the rise makes me think he's leaning more towards mages, which isn't surprising, considering we saw them with the tier early game.
Look at that comp. Four two-stars already.
That's a strong board.
Daniel. Okay.
That is a strong board.
I don't think he loses this one.
Yeah,
two-star Shen.
Super unfortunate for Pozonka because
Shen,
that's a win-loss, like you were saying earlier. Not
he's
what you
even
want
got
to
the
see.
Warrior comp going.
Like, here I thought Pozonka is in a position where, you know, they have a really strong board, potentially strong enough to win out, but, you know, damn, Daniel, board full of two-stars. Nothing you can really do there.
Yeah, really nothing you can do there. He is Mr. 100 alongside Ramkev.
Yeah, and something to note, obviously did not sell the Rise there to make Econ, which means that is a plan that they are heavily considering.
I don't know if I caught it, but he could have leveled up early before hitting level 5. It is basically a free roll at level 5.
Like pre-leveled?
Yeah, the pre-level, because usually right before the second carousel, I think this is the second carousel. Right before you go to the second carousel, you'll have 6 XP left to level up to 5. If you press the level up before the carousel, then the next time you're on your board, you're going to be level 5, and the shop's going to reroll as if you were level 5.
Right.
So it is usually a good idea if, let's say you're at like maybe like 14 gold, you're like not close to getting the next level of interest, but not far enough or at least not confident enough to roll down. You just hit the level up, and then you just go for 5, and then go from there. And now we're going to watch Ulu Damn Daniel. Interesting name, but we do have to keep in mind, he did place pretty high on the last TC. A lot of his name has been swirling around in that tournament.
Yeah, and it looks like here, Ulu Damn Daniel's board of 2 stars is going to be too much for Ramkev Shimmer Scale start to deal with. Even though this port is insanely strong from Ramkev, it's not strong
enough.
It's
already insane, yeah. Almost 4 Bruiser.
That's huge.
Has the Olaf already. Olaf, by the way, benefiting from Triforce augment that he has right there.
Yeah, triple. That augment basically.
I don't know which one that is. It might be the one where you get 3 costs. I don't remember.
I think that is the 3-3 cost one. But anyways, either way, Damn Daniel just defeats the other Mr. 100 in Ramkev, and that is huge. So hopefully he wins this last round, continues his win streak, goes on to a 5 streak, and is the only player that's going to get to do that in Snowball. So we'll find out here whether or not he's going to 5 streak, and it looks like 100%. Pokigom, this board is absolutely
not
very
so good.
Weak.
Yeah.
Not a
single 2-star is seen.
Might not even kill a unit, to be honest.
Honestly, yeah. But we might have taken down one at least.
This is interesting, though. There's an Elise with a Quicksilver, which means...
I've seen this. This is like the second time I've seen this tournament. Usually, it's not the best Elise items, but you do want that Rage Blade so you can just hit fast, bite fast, repel fast.
You also have to go back to the trees that those items can take you into. So with those items, you can go Olaf, you can go Siphon, you can go like Zaya potentially. There's a lot of different things you can do with those items. You're not really locked into anything just yet. So potentially Elise is just an item holder for something that they want to play in the future. And this is actually a trick that a lot of players might not know, where you put Olaf on the left side to get killed by the 2 Krugs. So that way you get the free 5 attack from his passive. And it's free attack.
It's free AD.
That's huge.
Yeah, free AD. Can't go wrong with that.
Nope. Can't go wrong. And If you are playing and you have an Olaf, always do that in the Krug round. Always make sure the Olaf dies.
That is a QS. Up in... He could put the QSS on the Olaf as well. Yeah, he's going to go for that straight away.
So it looks like Uwu, damn Daniel, kind of on the same game plan as other players in this game where they're just going Bloodthirster QSS. I mean, we have this on the Olaf instead of an Elise, but, you know, that's probably more ideal. This is exactly what you want. He already has two Olafs. If you find Olaf 2-star, that is absolutely huge this early in the game.
Oh, that's another Olaf. Look at that.
Yeah, it seems like so many players in this lobby are going Scale Scorn. Probably going to be really hard to actually
hit
the units.
Both guys named Dan are going Olaf comps. How fitting.
Yeah. I'm definitely...
Personally, I am also an Olaf fan, but it looks like Dim Dan Sum will be the one to win this, as he will potentially spoil Damn Daniel's streak. And there we go. Mr. 100 no more.
Yep. Dim Dan Sum on a win streak themselves.
He is on fire. Ooh. He could go for the recombobulator. I would like to see... I want to see that. That would be so funny. But no, he goes for the Stand United instead.
I like the Stand United here. You have a lot of traits active right now. Right now it's 4, so you're getting... What is it?
I think it's like 8 at the gray.
Is it like 2 or 4?
I think it's 2. So he's only getting 8, but still. Not bad.
Yeah, that's definitely not bad at all. Didn't hit Olaf 2 or anything, but you're chilling. You're at 30 econ, so your economy's looking pretty good.
Yeah.
You're already level 6.
If you're in this position, you want to go for Olaf carry, definitely you would level up at level 7. So he's trying to stock up that economy, get to that 50 gold, level up when he wants to, and then just hard roll at 7. Maybe even go for a slow roll. Slow roll might be the play here. But we'll see.
Ooh, Nami 3.
Oh, wow.
Already on the board from Poppin. That is that's pretty huge this early in the game. Not super surprised, though. Astros aren't really being highly contested in this lobby.
That is true. But then again, we might be seeing people that aren't really going Astral. We haven't really seen much on the other players' perspectives of this game so far. But right now, this Ryze is just absolutely shredding everyone.
Yeah, Ryze plus Nami here destroys... Ooh, damn Daniel's board pretty hard. And, we see
there's
Braum come
scorn.
Out. That's a Scale Scorn.
There's the Whisper still.
Will we see Diana come out soon and give the 4 Scale Scorn? That is really what damn Daniel needs here. And on top of that,
seems like everyone's going the Olaf comp, I feel like the damn Daniel is the one that... just prioritizing the Scale Scorn at the moment, but we'll see how other comps are looking at the moment. Yeah, I see a couple mages. Another not really overused, but like very popular comp.
Mm-hmm.
And there we go. More fighting happening for Uwudem Daniel, but he finally gets rid of his losing streak.
Yeah.
Soon enough.
So... Spicy Appy's here with the Shimmer Scale. Ezreal still generating gold. We saw Appy's have it right off the bat, so I'm curious to see what they transition this into. Their econ is very powerful. We see 4, so he's got at least 40 gold. Looking like a solid position, even though they're at 60 health. Okay, so we see a Swain Volibear. That looks like a Dragonmancer type.
We haven't really seen much Dragonmancer either.
Yeah, we haven't seen Swain at all or Volibear outside of like just using it early game. We haven't seen anybody actually commit to those strategies.
But we'll see this time around. What's the play here? Siphon going to get picked up for that Bruiser.
Yeah, do they end up going with
there the it is. There it is. There's
Whispers
the move.
Bruiser and ditch the Scale Scorn. Okay, so we sold Olaf. I like this a lot.
Yeah.
You need to put the items on the siphon if you're doing this. Those are very good siphon items. This is what I was talking about earlier, where you, even though you build the Bloodthirster Quicksilver early, there is so many compositions that can utilize those items. This is probably the ideal board for siphon right now, and then when you level up to 6, you just put in the an extra bruiser, get the 6 bruiser online, or pivot into something else depending on what you find. But super strong position for Daniel. Ooh. Facing Void Sin right now with the Varus comp going in. He's got 5 Varuses, so not super close to 3-starring it yet. But he's also looks like he's about to win.
Ooh. The Bloodthirster putting in work, but it's not going to be enough.
No, no. Void Sin's definitely wins this with the Varus, so he can kind of take his time if he's winning and find Varus 3. I think there might be 2 Varus players, though, in this lobby, so maybe that makes it a little harder.
Shuffling around the units. Not many units on the board right now, but in the position he is right now, he is in a really good spot to level up and just hit those units that he needs.
So we see a couple other siphons out on the battlefield right now. And this is the more traditional mage board that we see with the trainer start and, you know, you got the Nami, you have the Rise. Pizanka was the one that was in first place going into this. They did take the tier start, which was something that we talked about earlier, made me think, you know, mages are potentially what they're trying to go for,
yeah,
and
what
we
do you
see
know?
That here.
They're going mage with that early rot. He even got an early rise,
in
case anyone missed that. And that basically that's all you need. Just to go for that rise and then maybe into an Aoshin, maybe late towards the late game.
Yeah, that's pretty much been what the late game we've seen is that ends up winning is Aoshin.
We did see an Aurelion Soul one.
Yeah, I think that got second, though.
Yeah.
I don't think anybody's won with it. I think the main comp that we've seen take first place is Aoshin.
Ooh, he gets a lot of gold here. Still a rise, but he's not going to go for it. We'll go for the Talon. Quick level
up. So we chose to go Guinsoos over Giant Slayer, which means I think that actually makes you more flexible because now you can also go Xayah if you want still. You don't necessarily have to be committed to the Siphon as your carry.
But the Rage
there's still
Blade
a lot of things
on
you can
the
do.
Siphon. Okay. It's looking interesting. It's the matter of fact of can he make it any stronger? Still only a 1-star.
All right, looks like Ramkev has got this Swain 2 with a Guinsoos.
It's like the first Swain we've seen.
Yeah, so this is like a really interesting Shimmer Scale Swain. I don't even know. This is just super cool. And there's even an Ornn 2, which is absolutely huge.
Yeah.
Just kind of chilling in there.
He's kind of just there.
I don't even know if there's like synergies with the Ornn right now.
No, he doesn't win these. The Swain Twilight Shroud just doing, getting so much value out of those. And off we go. Third and last augment of the game. And it's going to be Gray.
Yeah, I feel like Second Wind is just the obvious choice there. Such a strong augment, especially when you're playing bruisers, which all frontline themselves, which means you're going to be taking a lot of damage early on in the fights. Decides to hold here for Econ. I'm curious to see what the next unit is. If they do have an opportunity to go 6 Brawler, do they do it, or do they just keep something like this Talon in for the guild buff? I really want to see what Ramkev is doing, though, if we can. Ramkev, if we can see what he's doing.
I am interested to see what Ramkev is up to. Because we see, like you mentioned, the Shimmer Scale itemed Swain doing some work.
And there is currently another Bruiser in, which gives the Rage. I guess it doesn't even give Rage Wing, but it does give Warrior, because we would already have Rage Wing without it. So the Bruiser is active, so Ornn's traits are not completely useless. But there are two legends here. This is interesting. I wonder if we'll see,
the legends comp.
I doubt it, honestly. I'd be very surprised.
It would be really cool, though.
But it would be really. I love me some good legend games.
True. I remember back, we did, like, me and my friends at, like, a church, we did, like, a for fun TFT tournament. And then the final eight lobby comes up, and some guy wins the entire thing in two games, because 16 games was the win. So basically, that was, like, two first games. And some guy won, got two first places by going legend comp both games. It was absolutely insane. No one really could find a Giant Slayer at all. It was just the stars just aligned for him. And that's the thing. Giant Slayer is honestly a very, very good item as of right now. So with so many good frontline units, especially onto the dragons also.
Ooh.
It's going to be
insane. See a Nami 3 and a Varus 3 coming out from Void Sin. I think this board is insanely strong.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
If there is a Gwinsoos at any time from Void Sin, this Varus is going to pop off super hard.
Unfortunately, it doesn't seem like that's the case. So, oh, yeah.
Yeah, Ramkev probably.
He's making a lot of money.
Uh-oh,
the rise is starting to pop off a little.
And honestly, that Varus stun was huge. Varus just took down the Swain right in the nick of time.
I think we just hit him with the Cast of Curse. I'm going to be real. Either way, the carousel coming in.
Yep.
The Bard is a decent option with that tier, but goes for the Hecarim instead.
So we see two Thieves, I was going to say two Thieves Gloves, but we see two crit components.
Yes,
what does he want to do with that?
Gloves. That is a very good question. Thieves Gloves is an option still, but doesn't look like he wants to go for that. The Jeweled Gauntlet is another option, but
I would actually love to see Jeweled Gauntlet be made here, put it on the Ornn. And then make a legend comp out of that. That'd be really funny. Just Ornn one-shotting people.
He does pick up the six Dragonmancer.
Yeah, this is a more standard way to go about this. You drop down from the Shimmer Scale.
Has he buffed a unit? I don't know if he has. It looks like the Volibear is the one that's being buffed, but I'm not entirely too sure.
He hasn't buffed a unit. That's actually a really huge mistake there.
Oh, whoa, wait a minute. That's a Yasuo, isn't it? A Yasuo. Hold up. Wait a minute.
It's an assassin Yasuo.
Yeah, so even more crit.
Yeah, I wonder if Ramkev would have won that if they had actually used the Dragonmancer's Blessing to give Swain the buff. Because six Dragonmancer buffs
is huge.
Then
also you gotta think about it. I don't know if he wants to be doing this, but I feel like he's doing that on purpose just to ride that loss streak. That is
no way. No way.
Yeah, but it's likely. And there's the Haoshindo. Ooh. He's thinking about it. He do be thinking about it. What is the play here, Ramkev?
Looks like
he's going to commit. He's going to commit to the Haoshin. He has the items for it.
Probably going to try to go 6 Tempest, but honestly, I don't know how good this Haoshin is, and we see the Dragonmancer's Blessing go on Volibear. Didn't forget about that this time. I don't know. This Haoshin really, really, really wants mana items. Like, this thing is not going to attack anytime soon, and when
Tempest,
it does...
Tempest buff is going to help him, though.
It's going to help him. It increases the attack speed, but... Is this going to be enough to clear the board? I don't think so with all the Nami healing. Like, this Nami has been healing throughout the duration.
Wait, no, never mind. The Ryze is just absolutely popping the hell off.
Yeah, Ryze is doing work here. And honestly, without the mana item, I kind of expected the Haoshin to be somewhat lackluster. Let's see what we can get here. Ooh. Maybe you just take the Infinity Edge and
Yeah, I think
go
that's
full
a better
damage. Hope that you know, Aushin can just get there with one cast and deal a ton of damage. I definitely have seen that happen before. We saw Spicy Appius do that with his Aushin in the game that he won. Just didn't have a mana item, but absolutely stacked the Aushin with damage items, and then it pretty much just one-shot the board.
Yeah.
But so Appius did have Aushin too, and it looks like Ramkev is still slow rolling on 8 here. Doesn't want to commit to leveling. I'm curious to see if he sells this Volibear or like what the plan is here. So the Volibear gets sold. The Nico is just in here as a solid unit. I like Nico a lot. Probably one of the best standalone units you can have. It's copying the Ornn right now. Probably will definitely get this is very interesting. Maybe that he scouted and saw that like assassins were a potential threat.
He's waiting.
And it looks like potentially, I mean, that might be the case here. Okay, Tempest goes off. Aushin gains attack speed. And with the IE JG, your auto attacks are actually doing damage now.
Yeah.
So you have like a ton of attack speed. You have the Gwinsu's getting procced on top of that. And now the Aushin's getting to a point where, you know, Spicy Appius goes 8th place, I believe.
Oh, no. There it is. Oh,
that is brutal.
That is a brutal
start. Spicy
Appius
going 8th place. That's a second Aushin. Only one more. And then Ramkev is looking like he's in a very, very good position.
Right now in the HP department, not looking so good, but he does have the Soraka to keep himself sustained a little bit longer.
I like this. You put in the Gnar over the Lulu. You lose.
You lose
not
Evoke,
much at all,
you lose
honestly.
Evoker, but you gain Shapeshifter and Jade.
I don't think you lose Evoker.
Or
I don't think you ever had
no,
it.
I think it was Mystic. It might have been.
You lose Mystic, but I don't think that matters too much.
Yeah, it's not.
The
it's
Jade
statue
is huge. That provides healing for the Aushin and attack speed. And honestly, Soraka is just solid. Gnar is just solid with the Shapeshifter. So Nico and Gnar both have more HP.
Here we go. The damage kicking in, but it's not going to be enough. The Elise still autoing away. The auto going to register, but it's not on the right person. And that just allows Aushin. Wait a minute.
That was huge. Elise's Repel dodged the Aushin damage. And
that is
then executed
that
the
is,
Aushin. That was
that's one
absolutely
way. That's
huge.
That's one way to win around. Oh,
yeah.
My God.
If Elise didn't get that execute and repel, it would have died to the
Aushin. This is looking good. Oh, the level 9 getting kicked in for Ramkev.
Yep, puts back in the Lulu, gets Mystic back. Does not have Evoker, but I think this Lulu is probably going to become something else once you know something else is available.
The Shroud doesn't quite connect on the...
I mean, that's fine. Your Shen's going to ult and help save your Ornn potentially, but didn't end up working out there.
All eyes on the Aesol, the Aushin, I mean.
Yeah, I mean, you're going to get executed, though, by the... you're going to get executed probably by the Yasuo. Oh, no.
Oh, that's too close. Too close.
Yeah, that was a close one. Ramkev down to just one more life. If he loses one more time, he is out, and nobody is close to getting out with him. So if he loses again, that would be devastating. That would be a 7th place. That would be absolutely unexpected for Spicy Appius and Ramkev, probably two of the best players here to go 8th and 7th.
They're holding hands. That's all I got to say. Holding hands 7th, 8th.
Really?
What me and my duo do all the time. Shout out to my TFT duo. I'm going to go cry in the corner now.
So Aushin 2 is really what we need to see here from Ramkev. We do see...
Oh, someone got something.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, my God. Look at that.
There it is.
Look at that. That's the reason why he pops off. There it is. The Ace Aoshin two-star.
Yeah, that's huge. Ooh, I think
he just saved himself six HP. Yeah, 6 HP in a dream. Does he win this? That is the question. That's what everyone's thinking. Look at the HPs on everyone else. 64 HP for first place. The next place is at 20.
So we see a double shroud.
This is do or die for Ramkev. And right now, he is in a very good position to at least keep himself alive for just a little bit longer. But this rise.
Let's see how much damage we do here.
The rise. Uh-oh.
Oh, man.
It doesn't hit the right targets. The rise is going to go again. And the stun is there, but the ASOL, he's going for one more. He's going to get it all.
Wow.
The one versus three. The one versus four onto the ZZ run. It's going to be close, but it looks like the ASOL will be able to get it, and he wins another round.
That was very close.
Oh, my God.
That was incredibly close. Just barely got there with the Aoshin 2.
That was a bit of my League of Legends play-by-play kicking in.
So we see the Shroud positioning here. Looks like he, I don't know. Does Shroud stack?
I don't think so. I think usually I just create a wider area. Yeah, like that.
Okay. I was like, I don't think it stacks.
It's like 35% extra tier spell cost, but if it stacked, that would have been, everyone would be just going vest into crit cloak. Brawler gloves.
Ooh,
or whatever.
Okay, Ornn cast, knocking up the Varus, which is huge.
ASOL still autoing away. The Bard ulti gonna stall a little bit.
Yeah, and here
and
comes
here
the Aoshin.
Here we go again.
Just barely enough to kill the Varus. And it looks like the Aoshin is gonna take this one.
Ramkev, we can hear him in the venue. He is popping the hell off.
Ramkev is very excited.
He is so excited right now. He is clutching so hard right now. The Soraka closing the HP gap.
Yeah, so Soraka, her ability, whenever she casts, you actually gain 2 HP.
Yes.
And then, funny enough, there was like this period of time where you would go Astral Soraka because when she casts and you're at 100 HP, she deals like 9,000 damage to your opponent. It's kind of like a joke, kind of like Tactician's Crown, when you get that off of Shimmer Scale, where it's like it just deals a bajillion damage. And that was actually a thing that was relevant in the meta for a very, very short period of time.
Ooh, just has enough Soraka income 3. To get to that 10 gold interest. And that's going to be a free Gargoyles. That was another ASOL Aoshin. And that is
a Zoe 2. How do you fit that in? I mean, I'm assuming you probably just drop the Lulu.
You could drop the Lulu and the Mystic buff, but that's up to you. That's
up
to him.
There's
no
way you don't.
There's no way you don't
do
it. Yeah, that is also a very fair point.
You have to play Zoe too. That's absolutely. I don't even think
that's
close.
I love how he has a rage wing augment, but he just doesn't have the resources for it. And
yeah, it just kind of.
I mean, what you got to do? What you got to do, man.
That was probably solid for him in the early game, and then, you know, he was able to transition out of it. Ooh. And now we're here.
With an Aoshin that's going to pop off again. Ooh.
Unless the Elise dodges it.
Unless
like
the Elise
it did last
does dodge.
Time.
Oh, the rappel coming in. Ramkev giving us away. He's just going to be able to win. And
Pokegom
is
going to go out at 7th. That is...
This is shocking. This is going to be one hell of a game for Ramkev if he's able to win it. Oh, that's a random daisy in the corner.
So Pokegon was actually the player that people thought would take this whole event. Even the pros were like, yeah, it's probably going to be Pokegon or Jirachi or Appius.
And
or Ramkev, everybody was like, yeah.
Okay, who's at the bottom? It's Pokegon and Spicy Apples. They actually do hold hands 7th and 8th. And those are also two of the big names here in Tactician's Crown 2.
All right, let's see if the Aoshin can get there
and
again.
And the Aoshin keep going. Is the Aoshin hype train still alive?
Oh, I think so, for
sure. I think so, too. Yeah, that is no doubt about it. Tempest Ulti's Tempest Maelstrom is coming through. And here we go. The lightning bolts of Alshit. I keep calling him Acel. I don't know why I do that.
Wait
a minute. Wait a minute.
Okay. No,
we're good.
We're good.
He survives. He survives the initial burst from Siphon. That's what made the difference.
Ironically, I think Soraka's healing enough. We were at 6 HP in a dream. Now we're at 14 HP.
Yeah.
Potentially, you can take a very, very small hit. Now that, that Soraka has been healing you.
We heard some happy feet out of Ramkev.
Oh, yeah.
Just hitting that Nico 2.
Ramkev, definitely one of the more animated players here. Very exciting to see.
He's in a good spot. I think so. The front line is there. Everything is lined up perfectly for Ramkev. It's a matter of fact of can you keep it going? Because right now he's not in that sudden death mode right now, but if he does go down here, it's going to be very devastating. But right now, big knockup from the Zoe.
Also, Braum died without casting from the Yasuo.
Oh, wait a minute. But the Acel, though, still putting in that work.
So did you see how much that Aushin healed? That was the Jade statue. I think it's 5% healing. Absolutely
coming
insane
in
because
he also has second wind.
He also got damage.
He also has second wind, so you have to put that into account as well.
Yeah.
So
much random healing coming out.
Oh my
here.
God, that's a dragon carousel.
It is, but I mean, really, what can Ramkev gain from that besides 10 gold? Like,
that's
it's not
true,
really big for Ramkev as it is for the other players. Like, we saw one person with Acel before. We probably know that Aushin is contested. So this might actually be huge for everyone else.
Very fair. There goes the Acel. And
we see a Soraka too, which means
nice. That's going to be like
that.
I think that's like 4 HP per round, I believe.
That means Ramkev might be able to actually just take another hit. That would be huge.
I think so. He is in a prime position.
Ooh, okay, so this is what I was talking about. There's another Aushin 2 because of that carousel.
Yeah, Pizanka.
Pizanka, who is our first place going into this,
ooh,
does
the
have
Shroud
that
does connect.
Too.
The Shroud connects on him. That's huge. Now this Aushin won't be able to pull off the ultimate soon enough. And, yeah, the bar ulti going to stall him a little more. Do the bolts connect onto the right people? Oh, wait. The burst from Aushin. It's the other Aushin's turn, but not going to be enough damage. And Ramkev wins the Aushin fight.
And there goes.
That's probably the most important fight he's ever going to take in this round. He knocks him out of the top four contention. And here we go. Top four in the first game of the finals. Ramkev just said, we are popping off.
I mean, he's not wrong.
He is not wrong at all. He is now in a comfortable second place on fire. Gauntlet, i.e. Rageblade, is the name for this Aushin. And if he plays his units, plays his cards right, he's just going to win this game number one.
Yeah. Let's see if the Braum actually gets, or the Bard gets to cast. Looks like it does. That is huge. It's going to cast on
I know we've been
most
watching,
of the team.
I know we've been watching Ramkev for a while, but this is the most interesting one we've seen. He was at 6 HP. He was at sudden death. But thanks to the Soraka and thanks to him hitting this 2-star Aushin, it couldn't have come at a better time.
6 HP into a dream. Eliminates Uwu Daniel there. And honestly, I don't know if anybody can contest him. Void Sin.
Okay. Well, Giant Slayer. Okay.
I mean, Giant Slayer doesn't
it's
really matter.
It's not bad.
Here.
You can just stick it on Zoe and then just go on your merry way. Let's see what else.
So Void Sin
got Dragon's Claw.
Didn't necessarily. Like, he can't
Dragon's
really make Claw's too many
Claw's not too bad here.
Dragon's Claw is huge. Dragon's Claw is
huge
as an item.
In terms of countering the Aushin burst?
I'm just thinking, like, how can he make his board stronger unit-wise? Because he lost the last fight against Ramkev, like, is there anything he can do to improve his board that will just help him win? Like, the Diana's not going to be able to get in there because of the positioning. The Olaf just wasn't strong enough to get through the front line last time. And honestly, like, where are you putting the Dragon's Claw? You put it on Zoe,
too? Look at that Alawi on Voight. I believe that was Voighton. Going for a little bit of a transition, going to get that on the Aswell. Does have the option to pick and choose his Shroud, and there it is, the best placement for the Shroud.
Yeah, Ramkev's fighting a ghost this round,
that
I
is
believe.
Yeah, that is also a ghost.
And so we see here that the Yasuo 2 is in over the Bard, which makes a ton of sense. I like that a lot.
Here we go. Here comes the lightning. Here comes the thunder. And
did not kill Varus, which is absolutely huge.
Uh-oh.
I actually think this is, I don't know.
Wait,
this is
I don't
gonna
know about
close.
This one.
No.
Watch
no,
that mana
no.
bar. It's coming close, but there we go. Ramkev. Yeah. That got a little dicey. Wait, that does mean...
6 HP to 25 HP.
But 25 HP, yes.
Voidsense lost to Dimdam some. Ramkev just beat Dimdam some. I think Ramkev is in a prime position to take it, especially if Voidsense lost to...
We'll see what happens, though.
The person Ramkev beat.
10 seconds left for these two to figure out what to do.
I mean,
as
this
a matter
board
of fact,
is pretty capped out at this point. I don't think there's really any improvements you can make. I think we're just all coming down to watching it play out.
Here we go. The Shroud does connect on a majority of the people on Dimdam Sum's board. Aoshin. It's all eyes on the Aoshin right now. Can he get the damage off? The Tempest buff goes in, but there's a big one. Here comes the lightning. And is it enough to keep himself alive? And the answer is yes, Dimdam Sum is out. But does that keep him alive in this one? Does
no,
he get a double kill?
Double kill. This
does
is
he
a
get
double
kill
every time.
I think it's a double kill. Yeah.
I think this
here
is a
we
double
go.
Kill every time, right?
Oh, we go. But the Alawi is pretty damn tanky. The Zoe doing a lot of work. Is it going to be enough?
No,
and it
is
a double kill. Ramkev.
A double kill for Ramkev.
Ramkev from 6 HP, sudden death. He makes it work, and
from
he gets
one
first
life
place.
To a first place. Ramkev
what a
takes
finish.
It. That was
he
absolutely
was,
huge.
Aoshin he was seventh
putting
place.
In work.
Yes, he was seventh place when he hit that two-star Aoshin.
He was. He was about to go. Hold. You said he was holding hands
was
with Spicy Appies.
Yeah, I know.
Eighth
and
seventh.
Then,
and then he hits the Aoshin 2.
And the rest
immediately.
Is history. Rest is history.
The rest is history. Like you said, that was huge. We've seen Aoshin take the majority of first places throughout
yeah,
this
I've
tournament.
Yeah, I've seen Ramkev out there right now. He is so damn excited right now. What a clutch from him.